I lost my two-factor authentication device. How do I sign in? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is actually a common fear when it comes to setting up two-factor authentication or even choosing to use two-factor authentication. Literally, what happens when you lose your second factor? The question is often, does that mean I can never log in again? And of course, the answer is no, of course you can log in. If you lose your second factor, regardless of that's your phone on which you get SMS or the phone that has the Google Authenticator app or maybe a YubiKey hardware type key, all that really means is that your next sign-in will be a little bit more work, but it'll still be possible and very secure. So another concern that people often have is when I've lost my second factor, that means that possibly somebody else has it. The issue, of course, is then, well, does that mean that they can sign in since they have my second factor? And the answer is no. Remember, two-factor authentication means two factors are required. That means that for you to sign in, you need to know both your password and have the second factor, at least the first time on a new device. But for the hacker to have any one of those, your password or the second factor, if they only have one, they can't sign in because they don't have the other. So it's just as safe as basically having your password compromised. They only have one half of the puzzle. And when that happens, okay, you will take some steps to deal with the other half. So what happens when you lose your second factor? Well, let's start with SMS two-factor authentication. If you're using SMS two-factor authentication, which, for the record, is better than no two-factor at all, then all you really need to do is contact your mobile provider and either have them disable your phone or get yourself a new phone and have your phone number ported to that new phone. When you use SMS as your two-factor authentication mechanism, the second factor isn't really the phone itself. The second factor is your phone number and your ability to receive a text message at that phone number is what proves you are you. So if you lose your phone, get a new phone, keep the same number, and you'll be fine. Okay, let's say you're not using SMS. You're using Authy or Google Authenticator, or perhaps you even have a hardware key, a YubiKey. Then, when you set up your account, you were probably encouraged, in some cases even forced, to set up recovery information that would be used to regain access to the account in exactly this situation. That recovery information could be anything from an alternate email address that you have control over to a different second factor, a second factor, totally valid in many cases, or potentially even a set of one-time use recovery codes that would take the place of your second factor exactly once. Any of those will then get you back into your account. They'll be a little bit more inconvenient, absolutely, but it is just inconvenience. It is not going to prevent you from getting in. And it's secure because each of those recovery mechanisms are still things that you and only you have access to. So they actually do serve as a kind of second factor. So when you lose your second factor, then step one is to regain access to your account using one of these recovery mechanisms that you've set up beforehand. Now, I've talked about setting up recovery mechanisms in the past and reminded people that they need to do it. That's normally for simply having lost your password. Like I said, when you set up second factor authentication, most services will not just encourage, but possibly even force you to set up this recovery mechanism. The one that's the most common are these recovery codes, these one-time use codes, and it is important to save them. Don't just click away. Save those somewhere so that if or when you lose your second factor, you have those codes to be able to get back in. Now, after you're back into your account, you need to immediately do something else. And that is turn off two-factor authentication for the device that you lost. For whatever it is you lost, turn it off. And if that's the only two-factor you have, then yes, at that point in time, your account is no longer protected with two-factor authentication. Great. Turn it back on. Get a new two-factor device, again, a replacement key, another phone, an authenticator app, whatever you choose for your second factor, and turn it back on again. That way, the process of turning it off and turning it on again actually resets your two-factor authentication and invalidates whatever it is that the other person who might have found your phone or stolen your key might have in their possession. The bottom line, though, is that you once again have a working second factor that will give you the security that you're looking for out of two-factor authentication. So like I said, losing your second factor is a lot like forgetting your password. You end up treating it the same way. If you forget your password, you recover your account and you set a new password. If you lose your second factor, you recover your account and you reset second two-factor authentication. It really is that simple. It's a little bit of inconvenience, but absolutely, you can get back into your account, and it is absolutely not a reason to avoid two-factor authentication. Trust me, two-factor authentication, any two-factor authentication, is much safer than no two-factor at all. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/167079. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.